Welcome dear students, in today's class we will learn about addition. Addition is represented by a plus sign. So when we add two numbers, there has to be a plus sign between them. The numbers that are added are called addends. For example, 5 and 7 are added to give 12. Here 5 and 7 are called addends and 12, which is the result, is called sum. So the result of addition is known as sum. There are certain words which gives us a clue that addition has to be performed, like total, add, more than, combines, joins, find the sum, plus, etc. For example, if 2 is added to 2, the result is 4. Here 2 and 2 are called addends and the result, that is 4, is called sum. Let us talk about zero property of addition. According to this, when you add zero to a number, result is the number itself. For example, if we are adding nothing, of course we will get the amount as it is. Let us practice some questions based on addition. In this question, we have to add the two given numbers, that is 2150 and 1150. We should always start doing addition starting from ones place. So when you are going to add ones place here, 0 plus 0 gives you 0. 5 plus 5 gives you 10. Now in this case, we have to write 0 at the bottom and 1 on the top. Now we are going to add this 1 to the remaining numbers on this place. That is 1 plus 1 plus 1, that gives you 3. And 2 plus 1 is definitely 3 only. So there are certain steps that we need to follow for adding the numbers. The first step is you have to regroup the numbers. For example, 569 is added to 458. Starting from ones place, we have to add 9 and 8. 9 plus 8 gives you 17, where 7 will be written at the bottom and 1 on the top. Now we are going to the next place, which is the tens place. On tens place, we have 6 plus 5, that gives you 11, but this carryover 1 will also be added. So 11 plus 1 gives you 12, and for 12, 2 will be written at the bottom and 1 on the top. Finally, we have hundreds place. On hundreds place, we have 5 and 4. 5 added to 4 gives you 9, but there is one carryover on the top that will make it 10. So the result will become 1027. Let us try and solve this question as a practice. So here we have 4 plus 8. 4 plus 8 gives you 12. So 1 on the top, 2 at the bottom. Now 9 plus 1 gives you 10 and 10 plus 4 is 14. Now we have 7 plus 2, that is 9, and we have to add the carryover also, that gives you 10. 0 at the bottom, 1 on the top. Finally, we have 5 plus 8, that gives you 13, but we have to add the carryover also, so it will become 14. So finally, you have got the sum as 14,042. When you will get a sum up to 10,000 place, you should always put a comma. So children, there are many questions given in your book for practicing addition. Please try and do it and explore this topic more. Thank you so much for watching.